Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. Let's begin with today's class. In today's class, we are going to study some more things about the earthquake, right? In our last class, we studied that because of destruction in the interior of the earth, there is an earthquake happen, right? So we are going to see today with the help of this picture and with help of some more information that how does an earthquake occur. The waves of the earthquake spread outward from the epicenter. See, in this picture you can see that this is the epicenter, and what happens, the waves of the earthquake moves towards the outward part, right? See, you can see it over here in the outward direction, and because of that there is a shift in this layers of the earth. And that is why earthquake is happening. The point on the surface of the earth exactly above the hypocenter or the focus is known as the epicenter, right? The intensity of the earthquake is felt the maximum around the epicenter. So you will feel the maximum earthquake or the maximum movement when you are on the epicenter or around the epicenter. The intensity of the earthquake decreases as we move above, away from the epicenter, and you will feel less, or you will feel earthquake less as you move backward from the epicenter. See, you can see over here this yellow line. As we go backward, the feel of the earthquake is less, right? The effect of an earthquake depends on the intensity of the earthquake. So it depends how fast is the fall happening in the interior of the earth. We can measure the intensity on the earthquake and know its point of origin or hypocenter with the help of a seismograph, right? So how can we know that there is more earthquake been felt in this particular place or which is the epicenter? So with the help of seismograph we can find the earthquake, the intensity of an earthquake. There are three main reasons for the occurrence of an earthquake. So here are the three reasons why an earthquake is happen. Let's see these three reasons. So the first reason is that earthquake caused by volcanic eruption, earthquake caused by strike slip faults, earthquake caused by subduction in an active subduction zone, right? So because of these three reasons, so because of a volcanic eruption, earthquake can be happen, or because of strike slip faults, right? Because of that there can be a movement inside the earth, and because of that earthquake happens. And the third one is earthquake caused by subduction in an active subduction zone. So the center of the earth is approximately 6037 kilometers from the earth's surface. So the center is approximately this much kilometer away from the earth's surface. So because of these three reasons, there is an earthquake happened, and the center of the earth is approximately this much kilometers from the earth surface. So to get you some more information about these three reasons because of occurring earthquake, I am going to send you one more video regarding this thing, these three reasons, okay? So from that you'll get a clear view about the earthquake, how, what are the main reasons of earthquake, okay? Now our next topic is volcano. Volcano refers to an opening in the earth's crust from which motion, lava, rock, fragments, ashes, dust and gases are injected below the Earth's surface. So how does a volcano occur? Basically, a volcano occurs because there is a very huge amount of pressure from inside the Earth, and then it comes out from a mountain or something, and there is a huge amount of lava rocks and many ashes, dust and gases been coming out, right? So this here you can see a volcano, right? So volcanic eruption occurs due to four main reasons. See here, there is four reasons how and volcano occurs and why does volcano occur. So because of first thing I told, that there is a very high temperature in the interior of the Earth, then there is the creation of magma, which means a fluid type of fire, you can tell, and which has a very huge amount of fire heat coming out, and because of that there can be a volcanic eruption. Creation of gases and vapor. One more thing, that is, there are many gases and many vapors being created inside the Earth's crust, then rising of magma towards the Earth surface. And when magma, which means the liquid fire, which has been increasing, and because of that there is a very high pressure from inside the Earth, and that is why it comes towards the surface of the Earth, and there is a volcanic eruption. The magma is pushed upwards by the gases laying under the magma. Secondly, the water percolating through the cracks and openings of weak rock surface turns into great force. So from where does this gases or this fire come out? Basically, it comes out from the cracks which are there in the rocks. See, mostly mountains are made up of rocks, right? So from that rocks, from that cracks of opening, there is a very great pressure, and vapors and fire comes out of that rocks. The vapors also causes magma to rise upwards. The gases present in the magma rich near the surface of the Earth and erupt with high pressure in form of lava, ash, gases, rock piece or various shapes and size, etc. So because of that huge pressure, we can see many things like lava, ash, gases, rock piece, etc. Right? You can see all these things from the underground, right? From the force which came from inside the Earth's crust, and this is known as a volcano. All this volcano residuals comes on the surface of the Earth and from a mountain like structure. So from where does this come out? From a mountain like structure. If the amount of gases and vapors is more and the wind gases is less, and the wind is broad and long, then the molten lava comes out slowly and spreads itself on the Earth's surface. So basically it is talking about this. You can see this shape which has been created because of the very huge pressure of gases and many different vapors. So how does it happens? Like, see, if the this thing, you can see, if the hole which has been over there is very big, then the pressure of the gas is very high, right? But if this mouth or this shape is narrow, then there is a very less eruption, right? Where is the vapors or the gases or the ash comes out very slowly, and it started settling in the surface of the Earth, right? So it gets slowly it cools down and it becomes a layer of a Earth, right? So this is how it volcano is being erupted, and these are the things what happens during a volcano. So over here I'm going to stop with our chapter. We'll continue the chapter in the next class. Thank you.